Hey everyone, so in this video I'll be explaining you why we are getting this promise pending as a response from our backend calls while using React.js frontend. So I'll be explaining you the reason as well as the solution for this. So before that, here I'm having a simple fetch function. I'm not using any library like Axios. It's just a simple fetch function that I'm having over here, and I'm just passing two parameters, which are going to be the username and password, and after that, that hits the backend. And from my backend, I'm just sending a response over here. If my admin and password matches, I'm just sending it as a response. So simple thing. So if this works fine, I'll be getting a list as a response. But it's not now, I'm just getting a promise pending as a response. So the issue is actually in my code. So here I'm having a fetch function, right? And after that, I'm having a then function. And inside this then function, I'm checking if I've got a response as okay. So if I'm not getting a response as okay, I'm just throwing an error. Else I'm just trying to console.log that response. So this console.log is the one that you see over here. And now for the reason why we are getting a promise as console logged, because this response.json that I'm printing over is also a promise, and we need to also use another then function for this response.json to be displayed. So for example, this returns a promise, this fetch returns a promise. We are using a then function, like a then callback function. And after that, we are trying to console the response. But this response.json also returns a promise. That's the reason why we are getting promise pending. So the simplest solution is we need to have one more then function after this. So I hope you'll be having the catch function over here. What you're doing is just go above the top after this then function. Okay, after the first then function, just put dot then. And basically, you can just copy the previous one. You're just going to have an arrow function like this. Rather than consoling log the response.json, you can just return this to the next then function, which will be caught by it. So it's going to be return response.json like this. And inside this then function, we'll be having something called as data. And inside the function, let me just console.log data. So in my case, I'm just consoling.logging it. In case if you want to like set it in a use state, you can do it. So I'm saving it now. The application is restarted. I will refresh it anyways. So the console is cleared. Yeah, console is cleared. I'll type my username and password and click on submit. And here you can see this time I'm not getting any promise pending, but rather than that, I'm getting the data. So this is the one that I'm sending from my backend. So this is the solution. And in case if you're not using these kind of then functions, in case if you are using async, try adding the await keyword. Okay, that could be also another reason for this error to get resolved. So just try adding another then function before your catch. So this is the solution, guys. And in case if you have any other ways better than this, make sure that you comment it down. I would love to read that. And I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I have a lot of videos in Gemini AI, OpenAI APIs, as well as other programming and AI videos also. Check the playlist. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.